Hey train friends, welcome back to another catalog review. This one is for the Lionel 2024 Volume 2 catalog. It just dropped today on July 17th, and we're going to go check it out today on PGH Train Fanatic. Don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section and like this video. I really appreciate it. Let me know what you think about the catalog, an item that you liked or maybe disliked, what you would have wished for, whatever you can think of. So let's go ahead and check out this catalog. It's going to be a little bit shorter than the Volume 1. And we're going to get started with O-Scale, obviously, and the new Visionline GG1s. And I'll tell you what, this Conrail GG1 looks really absolutely fantastic, actually. And the GG1s were released, I think, back in like the 2014-ish time frame, around there, give or take a year. And they were really cool. I did a review on one, and they're coming back in, and they're priced at $16.99. They are Visionline, really cool. It has like the flashing arcing lights on the pantographs, and they move up and down depending on which direction you're going. And they are really cool. They do require 072 curves. And you can see here is the Congressional and that beautiful silver paint scheme with the red stripe, and they have passenger cars to match that. And then here is the Senator and that nice Tuscan with the 5 gold stripes, and then also matching those same cars down below. And then moving along, here is the Spirit of St. Louis. Got the Brunswick with the 5 stripes. And then you have down below the Spirit of St. Louis passenger cars. You can get a pack of 4 for $999, or the 2-pack with the Station Sounds Diner for $699. Man, that's a lot. All right. And then here is the Penn Central GG1s. And these look fantastic. I really like the one with the white and the red Penn Central logo. And then also down below, more aluminum Station Sounds cars and passenger cars to match your Penn Central GG1s. Pretty awesome. Also, I forgot to mention, these do have the 4-digit addressing. And actually, all of the new Lionel legacy engines have 4-digit addressing in this catalog, I noticed. So that's a really cool feature. Here is the United States Savings Bond GG1. And you can see there's like a nice assorted pack of different variety of passenger cars. It's actually really cool. I kind of like the variety. Very nice. And then here is another Amtrak GG1 with some Amtrak aluminum passenger cars as well. And then the American Railroads, that's in that beautiful blue paint scheme, and the blue matching passenger cars as well. And then here's a cool page to look at. First of all, let's talk about the old rivets GG1 down there. You can see that's the old rivets where it has the exposed rivet detail. And I just love that one. Honestly, if I were to get a GG1, this would be the one I would order. I just love that, the detail on that one. And then if you look up above, there is an entire set, a GG1 set, and it's comes in priced at $2,599. But that includes, obviously, the GG1, a hotbox reefer, the Penn Salt 8,000-gallon tank car, the trailer on the flat car with 2 trailers, a Timken Freight Sounds box car, the Pennsylvania X31 boxcar, and a Pennsylvania Vision Sounds N5 cabin car. So that's actually a lot of bang for your buck there, considering you're getting a hotbox reefer plus a sound boxcar and another caboose with sound. That's three items with sound in that set. Pretty cool. And then over here on the right side, we have Pennsylvania Vision cabin cars, N5 cabin cars, and these are the ones that have the sound in them. And they are priced at $299. They are cool. I ended up getting one. I haven't done a review on it yet. Here's another Vision GG1 set. This one is the Vision post-war inspired 21-24 W Madison set. And you can see it comes with those post-war inspired passenger cars. Really nice. And you can get, And you can get the Station Sounds baggage car, and the end car looks really cool too. Sorry, I keep bumping into that. I apologize. All right, and then here is a LCCA exclusive Tuscan GG1 with the red stripes and passenger cars to match it down below. Now, here is a page that I'm going to kind of gripe about. I'm going to be honest. I was looking at pricing of these before I did this review, and these are the baggage cars, the B60s, and they are $300 for one baggage car. And I just think that that is just kind of outrageous. When you look back, and I saved it on this page, this is from 2017. This is how much they were in 2017. The same exact cars, they were $159. So the almost double price increase doesn't make any sense to me. The inflation has gone up, but not that much. That's just absolutely ridiculous. Anyways, there's all your choices. I guess they think you're going to buy a baggage car if you buy a GG1. Like, you have to have a $300 baggage car. So I don't know. If you do want one, they're nice. I have one. But look for an older one. That's my suggestion. And here's the Vision baggage cars. So these ones have sound. So you get sound for only an extra $100. So I just don't, the price difference there, I don't know. They're nice. Don't get me wrong. $499 though for a baggage car. I'm going to pass. All right, we're on to the legacy diesel. Sorry, I had to be honest with that because I just think that somebody at Lionel needs to review the prices on those things. It's a baggage car, for crying out loud. All right, legacy diesels, SD70 ACEs. And this is the returning line of the Norfolk Southern Heritage units. They are $699, fairly reasonably priced. You can get non-powered units as well, Penn Central, the Reading lines, and the Savannah and Atlanta. All very nice. You can also get the Wabash and the Virginian and this new Ferromex paint scheme. I really like the Ferromex. That's really cool looking. And that's the railroad from Mexico. Very cool. All right. And next up are SD70M-2s over here on the left. And just a few of them. There's the Grand Trunk, the Maine Northern, and the Susquehanna. I really like the Grand Trunk or the Susquehanna. The Grand Trunk kind of stands out. I like the red, white, and blue. They are $699 also. They have the Kinematic Pilot. And you can see they also say four-digit addressing. So, like I said, all of the new legacy engines, not just the Vision line, have four-digit addressing. So, thumbs up to Lionel for that one, for sure. Alright, and then over on the right-hand side, we have the C-liners that are returning. C-liners come priced at $599 for the single leading unit, and then you can get the rear unit for the same price or the matching, so that you could either use either one, as they're both powered, obviously. And then you can get a B unit super base. Those are $499. All right, and so that one's obviously Canadian National. On this page, we have Canadian Pacific, then Milwaukee Road, which those two are really sharp, the paint scheme. I mean, honestly, all these are. The New York Central and the Pennsylvania with the antenna on the roof. That's awesome too. Oh, real quickly, the C-liners operate on 031 curve, so those are good for smaller layouts. All right, next up are the PAA sets with super base option. And you can see here they are two powered units. The rear unit is just powered with smoke, no sounds in that one. No sound in it, I'm sorry. If you want an extra sound unit, you get the super base. The AAs are priced at $1,200 and $500 for a super base. And I love that war bonnet paint scheme, the Erie, Erie. New Haven, Southern, and the Southern Pacific. So those are great. They do operate on 036 curve. So pretty fairly tight curves as well, too. This is the Nickel Plate Limited set. You can see that's actually not a set. I shouldn't say a set. Set of AA units, but they're sharp, and you can see they have passenger cars to match that as well. And then we have some Halloween items, and you can see there's a nice-looking set of Halloween PAAs. And you can get those, and you can get custom spooky sounds in your station sounds diner cars to match it. Really cool. I like that set. Really sharp looking. I think that's going to be a home run set. And then over on, whoops, sorry, I keep bumping that. And then over on the right, we have a Whispering Rails Halloween J3A Hudson for $799. This is a Lion Chief Plus 2.0 engine, so that's a really nice looking engine. And you can see it glows in the dark too. That's kind of cool. All right, and then we have some more Halloween items. We have a few things here, a tank car and a flat car. This tank car has like a liquid inside of it. That's pretty cool. And then over here we have SW1s. And these are nice little switching diesels. They do operate on 031 curves. They have the fixed pilot in the front. It doesn't move at all, which is kind of cool. They are priced at $549. And you can see four-digit addressing even in these as well. So there's Amtrak, Cargill. This one always tongue twists me. Dubox Sand. I don't know. Western Pacific, Lehigh, New York Central, and the manufacturer's JCT. All right, now we have SD40-2s coming back again. One of my favorite diesels. I love SD40-2s. And they are priced at $649.99. You can also get a matching unit that is not pictured. And this Aberdeen Carolina Western is gorgeous with that dark green, white, and the purple details. Love that. And then you can also have the Chicago Northwestern or Canadian Pacific. And additionally, there are Reading and Northern, Susquehanna, VMV, and Sioux. Awesome. I like the ones with the blinking cab light on the roof. Very nice. And you can see some of them have, they're showing some that have ditch lights. Like that one didn't have ditch lights. This one here, these two have them. So I think it's kind of road specific details. That's kind of cool. All right, now we're on to Legacy Steam. I noticed this catalog's sort of backwards. Usually Steam comes before Diesel, but in this one they did Diesel before Steam. And here is the big boy. And it's not a big boy, a Y6B. That's a big steam engine. And wow, these look beautiful. The Norfolk and Western was famous for these locomotives. And you can see, apparently these are new. They have the oval door on the front of the boiler. I like that look. They are priced at a whopping $1,999. But it's a big steam engine, and I get it. It's really nice. They do have pop-off valve steam and whistle smoke steam, plus obviously the stack steam. So there's a sort of almost Visionline-ish features in these. They do require 072 curves. They are 30 inches in length, and they do have four-digit addressing, so that's awesome. And on the next page, there are some fantasy scheme Y6Bs. There is a Pennsylvania, which I freaking love, even though it's a fantasy, but I love it. And then the Santa Fe, Union Pacific, and I don't know if Union Pacific had Y6Bs or not. Maybe not. I know they have Y3s, but and then the Great Northern. I'll tell you what, honestly, the Great Northern is probably the best looking one out of them all. Look at that. That is beautiful. All right, so on to the next steam engine, and it is the Mountain. This is a USRA Light Mountain. And it's coming in at $1,599, and it's a 482, and it does operate on 054 curves, and there's quite a few different variations here. There's that Alaska Mountain, Santa Fe Mountain, the Seaboard. I like the Seaboard. Look at that beautiful color on that Seaboard locomotive. Wow. The NC and St. Louis right there. Over on the right, there's a New Haven. That beautiful green Southern Mountain, the Tennessee Central, and then this one right here is just absolutely breathtaking. The blue Texas and Pacific. And you can see a couple of these actually have brass tenders, and the price is $100 more for the one that has the brass tender on it. But that Texas and Pacific one is going to be the knockout of all of them, I think. All right, moving along is Heavy Mikados. Whoops, sorry, skipped the page. Alright, so the Heavy Mikados, they are $13.99 and they operate on 054 curves. They're 23 inches in length, and there's quite a few different ones. They do have whistle smoke. I think I forgot to mention that the Heavy Mikados also have whistle smoke. Whoops, wrong way. Yeah, they do. Alright, and sorry about that, guys. My stupid mouse. Alright, then the... So the Heavy Mikados have quite a few different road names as well. And Central New Jersey, the EJ&E, the Great Northern, which is probably the most eye-catching out of them all, the Louisville and Nashville, the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie, and the Soo Line. Okay, next are the 060s. These are back, and they are awesome locomotives. I actually have the Pennsylvania one, and I never did a review on it. They're awesome little steam switchers. They have a swinging bell feature, and that's a really cool Visionline-ish feature. And they operate on 031 curves. They are priced at $899. Atlantic Coastline, Baltimore and Ohio, Chicago, Northwestern, Grand Trunk, Nickel Plate Road, and a Union Pacific. And I know a friend of mine has been waiting for a Union Pacific steam switcher for a long time. And there you go, buddy. You finally got one. My buddy Darren. All right. And next up is the New Haven Minuteman Freight Set. And it's up here. You can see it comes with the New Haven Mountain. And it has a boxcar with sound and a hopper, another boxcar, and then a caboose. The caboose on these do not have sound. I was looking at that before. And then down below is this amazing Norfolk and Western King Coal Set. And you can see that comes with the Norfolk and Western Y6B and the Norfolk and Western hoppers, 12 of them to be exact, and a caboose. And you can see it's priced at $3,000 basically. Obviously, all these prices are MSRP. If you go through a reputable dealer, you can get a good pre-order price, usually for at least 10% less than what's listed here. All right, next are the cabin car cabooses. And these are really great looking. There's a Conrail, Long Island, Pennsylvania, Pennsylvania War Bonds, and the Penn Central. I like this War Bonds one. These are priced at $125. And then here's some others. The one on the left is the Reading Seashore line. That's a regular one. And then the two on the right are Vision. These ones have sound. So the Penn Central and the Long Island have sound. Very cool. All right, and then we have new boxcars. These are X31 boxcars. You can see there's quite a few different variations from on the Pennsylvania Railroad. And then the merchandise service on the right, and the Penn Central, and even a Seaboard version. These are priced at $99 a piece, and they operate on 031 curves, which most boxcars do. All right, so we have some new flat cars. These flat cars actually look really cool. They are like four truck flat cars, and they have some pretty neat ones actually. This one up here, this AEC, is a glowing one. It glows in the dark, and I really like them a lot. I like this one particularly for myself. Westinghouse is a Pittsburgh area company, so I'm gonna go for the Westinghouse heavy duty flat car for sure. Those need 042 curves, just so you know. And then on the right-hand side, we have, they're just called 8,000-gallon tank cars. There's liquid inside of that one, so it's priced a little bit more. It's $130, but the three below are priced at $99 apiece. All right, and then we have hot box reefers again. These were in the last catalog. So they are not Visionline, but they have sounds in them. And they are $300. You can see there's a few different new road names. Illinois Central, the Atlantic Coastline looks good, the Great Northern, and that Railway Express agency. And I didn't mention this O'Leary Dairies. That one actually is really cool, like that, with the cow on it. On the right, there's new trailer on flat cars, otherwise known as TOFC, with two trailers. And I really like these two Army flat cars. Those are nice. They're priced a little bit high. I mean they're really detailed cars. They're nice. They have wood decks and everything, but they're $160. Chicago Northwestern and the Pacific Electric, and then Alaska's sharp too. All right, and then next up are ribside box cars. These ones actually look really great. They all are Milwaukee Road. You can see there's all bunch of different variations, and they're priced pretty good actually. They're $79 a piece. And I like the coloration on all those. All right, next up are AC2 hoppers, and these look fantastic, actually. You can see there's priced at $85 a piece, and there's the Atlantic Coastline, DLW, Great Northern, Soo Line, the shipper's car line, and the McMillan feed mills. I kind of like the McMillan feed mills. Or the Great Northern. I like the Great Northern with the logo on the side. All right, these are four-bay covered hoppers that are, some of them are weathered, and they are priced at $99 a piece, and I think these look fantastic, actually. The one that really pops to me is this AEX, whoops, oh shoot, sorry. This one right here, this AEX with that old Rock Island logo on it and all the rust. Those are pretty awesome. I wouldn't mind having like all four of those weathered hoppers. I like that, and with the graffiti on them. And then there's just some other ones over here, the Rio Grande and the Cumberland Chemical. That one's actually really sharp too, with that light blue color. All right, so here we have three-bay hoppers with peaked ends. And these are great-looking hoppers. I love that peak on the end. They're priced at $85 a piece. Now, just so you know, these do not come with a coal load. You have to buy the coal load separately. Kind of stinks, but I guess, you know, for $85, I don't know. You can get the three packs for $250. Again, you can order these for less, pre-order from reputable dealers. There's a Norfolk and Western and a Pennsylvania. You can match up with your Y6Bs. And then over here, here's the coal loads you can buy. So for six of them, they cost $23, which isn't bad. But I mean, it's a piece of plastic. Just give you the plastic with the car. You know, I don't know. Why make people buy it separate? I guess maybe there's some people that like to make their own custom loads and don't need who knows? I'm not trying to make sense of it. All right, we're going into traditional O-gauge. You can see here's a new Area 51 set. First, they're talking about how you can control the trains with the Cab 3 Bluetooth control, the universal remote. And tell you what, these Lionmaster J3A Hudsons over here on the right look absolutely gorgeous. They are priced at $799. They have Lion Chief Plus 2.0. The only thing that I will gripe about with these is the Lionmaster line used to be Legacy. And when it was Legacy, it was priced about the same, relatively mediocre priced. And that's what this is at. It's at $800. So my feeling on these is these should have been Legacy Lionmaster engines, not Lion Chief Plus 2.0. For Lion Chief Plus 2.0, these should be like, they should be like 100 or 150 less. For $800, you should be getting Legacy in these. Just my opinion. Like I've had like Lionmaster engines in the past, and you know they were priced around that point or more for like a Challenger, but a Challenger is way bigger than this. But anyways, these are gorgeous. The New York Central is great looking. That the red pacemaker one, that's going to be the home run right there. But I'll tell you what, the one that really stands out to me is this Lionel Lions. It makes me think of an engine that I had and still have from when I was a kid, and I really like that one. If I were to get one, I probably would actually get that one. All right, moving along here, there are GP38s with Lion Chief Plus 2.0. You can see there's some great-looking paint schemes there as well. They're $499. They operate on 031 curves. Great for small layouts. Here is a CPKC. I was afraid I was going to say that. Get a tongue twist on that one. The KPC, see, I did it. CPKC Maxi Stack Set for $379.99. You can get an extra car there. And then here is the Area 51, the new freight set. And you can see it comes with the locomotive and a few freight cars. Looks fantastic. You can buy some extra additional cars as well. That looks great. And then there's some accessories you can buy, like a tank car accident with a glowing green load. I love that. Whoops. Oh, geez, sorry. And then you can get this Area 51 Hotbox Reefer. And the only thing that I think that would have been... The only thing that I thought would have been really cool with this Hotbox Reefer is if it was glowing like green because of the Area 51 and it looked like it was spilling like some toxic spew or something. But here's one of those heavy-duty flat cars, and this one glows in the dark as well, Area 51. That's pretty awesome. I kind of like that as well. It's, honestly, I wouldn't mind having both that and that Westinghouse one. This is also really cool. This tank car, and it looks like there's an alien floating inside with liquid. Love that. And then on the right, one of my favorite Halloween-ish themed movies, Beetlejuice. I love Beetlejuice so much. So happy they're coming out with these box cars. And this one here, you can see it's a lighted box car. I'm guessing the lights are in the Beetlejuice sign. And yeah, it does say Beetlejuice sign is illuminated. That's really cool. I really wouldn't mind having one of those. And then there's a couple others down below. They're just regular box cars as well. Over here we have American History box cars you can purchase. These are $99 a piece. Couple cabooses. This new caboose stand accessory is really neat. That comes with the Brakeman Bill's caboose. It has like little awnings on it and a stand here. Really neat. And there's the flashing the crossing gates with the flashers on it. You can buy for your fast track. And then here's just the Lionel Base 3. These are actually arriving at dealers right now as we speak. And those are going to go fast. Personally, I did not order one, so if you're gonna try to find a review here, I may pick one up, but honestly, I didn't order one, so it's gonna be a last minute thing if I happen to get one, just because I have two legacy systems, I don't really need that as on top of it, but you can see you can run it with the Cab 3 app, and it's a free download, or there's the regular Cab 1 remotes that are still available. There's some items you can see Lionel offers custom run opportunities. Yada, yada, yada. Here's the... I was watching the yada, yada, yada Seinfeld episode earlier. I wanted to sneak that in there somewhere. And then here's the Lionel Collectors of Club of America advertisement trying to get you to join, which you should join, the LCCCA. So that pretty much does it for the catalog, guys. I tried to end it with a laugh and just let you know, I want to see what you guys think of the catalog. Don't forget, again, to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment for the video. I really appreciate it, guys. Thanks so much for watching this catalog review. We'll see you next time. Take care.